backstage at Rockstock, and I've not got just one, but two bona fide rock stars in front of me, Spike from the Quireboys and Mr. Fish. How the hell are both of you?
Fish from, it used to be in Marillion, didn't it? I'm sorry.
Allegedly.
I was listening to you on the radio coming up with the car. I'm lying because
no, we've known each other for years.
You must have known each other from way back in the actual day.
Yeah, in the actual days.
In the actual
real
day.
Days.
And I'm assuming that if we stood here all night, you wouldn't finish telling stories about what you two used to get up to, right?
We not got up to nothing.
Nothing. I wouldn't believe that from you.
We were actually on EMI together.
Right.
Weren't we?
Yeah.
And did you manage to catch the Quireboys set earlier on?
Yeah, it was brilliant. It was great to see them. I did an 8-hour drive down from Edinburgh, and it was And I was like, oh, wow, I didn't even know they were on tonight. So it was like, we checked in the chalet and it was like, bang, into the pub, and then bang, straight through the Spikes on stage.
It's
lovely. We've done a couple of gigs recently. We did acoustic gigs.
On the
English Acoustic Festival, or whatever.
Yes.
And there's all sorts going on for you at the moment, you've both got albums out.
Can I tell you something very strange tonight? Do you know that guy who played bass? Tonight, he'd never ever played with us before.
He didn't sound like that from here.
He never played with us before.
What's the story behind that then?
Because our bass player is in Barbados at the minute on holiday.
As they do,
we've been on tour for like months.
I don't think Europe. They need me.
We've been on tour in Europe for months, and I've flown in. We've had four drummers in the past 5 months.
Since we left
this tour. And so our last drummer was Simon, who's the drummer in Squeeze. You know Simon Hansen?
Yeah.
And it's been a nightmare. And then so tonight, I met the bass player for the first time tonight.
But it worked.
It totally worked.
We didn't even rehearse for this. To be honest.
What did you think of the Rockstock crowd?
I thought it was great tonight.
Yeah.
It was very strange because we were just in Norway and we were doing these. I don't know if you've ever done these cruise ships. We're doing one in March.
No, yeah.
We're going to the. It's a cruise ship where you go to Florida, but they did Florida
in
the Bahamas.
Can I come?
But there's a lot where you go from Norway to Finland.
Nice.
And we're doing one the other night. And I looked at Griff, that's what I mentioned on stage tonight. It looked exactly the same stage.
Right.
As when we were on the ship the other night.
This could have very nearly been underwater, but thank God it wasn't.
Well, I heard about that, yeah.
Yeah, but we're,
isn't it lovely to see? He was presenting the Classic Rock Awards.
So we saw, pretty good job.
Unfortunately, I wasn't.
I didn't swear at all. I didn't believe it. I didn't have a drink and I didn't swear at all.
But what
I was getting messages of people saying, do not swear. Please don't swear.
What happened when you had to give the Rock Legend Award to yourself? Have you done that yet?
I wish. I will never get that.
No, you will.
I will be living in the Black Forest in Germany.
I'm going to give you loads of lavender.
Well, look, you had loads and loads of practice presenting anyway, because you used to present on Planet Rock, didn't you? Fish on Friday. That's where we got to know each other.
But there's a big difference between presenting on a radio show.
And then
it's really freaky. It's like, you know, you're kind of introducing like Jimmy Page on stage and like, you know, John Mayall and things like that and Walter Trout, and you're kind of going like, wow. And there was a lot of people like Scott Gorham and things that I hadn't seen for a long time, and it was like, and your old mate Ginger, and it was like kind of, it was really weird being up there.
Jimmy Page better than Ginger.
Well, look, I don't think we could probably broadcast all your Jimmy Page stories, but it's been lovely to talk to you. What, before we let you go, best thing about being out there tonight in front of the Rockstock crowd, what was
playing
the
our
thing?
New single, which is out now,
and it's called
Mother Mary for Christmas,
off the album, which is called
The Beautiful Curse.
There you go, Steve.
So download it now. It's all for charity. Oh, it's not really, is it?
Is it not?
Okay. No, it's okay.